Good afternoon. Welcome to the Green 2016 Green Engineering Tech Expo. I'm Dustin Wietoff, Regional Distribution Sales Manager with Goulds Pumps.
I'm Jeff Fischel. I'm the Regional Sales Manager for ITT Goulds Pumps.
And today we're talking about our second generation i-ALERT2 24/7 condition monitor. This is it's a Bluetooth-enabled device, and we're able to use a Bluetooth-equipped smartphone or tablet to tap into the i-ALERT's memory. So what this enables the user to do, pan back over to, the real value in the i-ALERT2 is the fact that we're looking at data 24/7, and also we are able to now enable the user to monitor, quickly and efficiently monitor large numbers of machines at the same time. So what we're looking at here is the actual i-ALERT2 app. This is available on the iTunes App Store and as well as Google Play for Android. And the first screen that we're looking at here is going to be the scan screen or sync screen, where we're looking at all i-ALERT2s that are within communication range, and that range is anywhere from 30 to 100 feet line of sight. So we've got 5 i-ALERTs within communication range here. The colored circle icon is giving us the current condition or current running status of the machine. Green just tells us everything is running smooth, good to go. You know, the nice thing about that is if you have an operator or somebody go out and check, do a walk through the plant, check all the machines, they get green circles. They can kind of just ignore those. They know the machine is running good. The one on top there, that's what we've got on our iframe cutaway and our vibration table here. So the vibration table actually does vibrate, and it's got a on the back there, it's got a dial with an adjustable frequency and amplitude. So that red X is telling us that we've got a vibration problem with this particular machine. Now, if we want to go ahead and dive into that, we're going to take a closer look at the machine that we have an issue with that's in an alarm condition. And the i-ALERT's looking at the data continuously. So you can see here, the dashboard is giving us the real-time data in all three axes. It's a triaxial accelerometer. Temperature, it's tracking runtime for us and also gives us the battery life. Battery life on the i-ALERT is 3 to 5 years, depending on usage. It's also, the reason the battery is not replaceable is the fact that we potted the back with epoxy to make it suitable for class 1, div 1. Hazardous area classifications. So the i-ALERT, essentially what it does is every 5 minutes, it collects a snapshot of the data, vibration and temperature, brings that back to the warning and alarm levels, which are set either automatically by the i-ALERT after 25 hours of runtime, or the user can go in after the fact and adjust those. And it's checking to see if there's a warning or alarm level condition. If the temperature and vibration are below those levels, that's where you'll get the green status icon. If it's in a warning level, the status icon would be yellow and red for an alarm level condition. So you can see here in the radial axis, we've got a high level of vibration, 1.6 inches per second. So that's given us an alarm level condition. Upon going into an alarm condition, we're plotting on the trend vibration and temperature data every 5 minutes, and we also capture an FFT. So we have a vibration spectrum the moment the machine enters into an alarm condition. If I want to go in and take a closer look at the trend, I would simply click on any one of these, and now I can zoom out, zoom in. All right, and you can also press and hold and cursor will pop up so you can identify the peaks and go in and take a closer look if you want to identify exactly when your vibration and temperature started to spike. Once we get out past 30 days, we'll take a look at the weekly averages here for temperature, and we can plot the vibration as well. If I want to look at the raw data, I can generate a CSV file with the date and timestamp and the actual readings that were collected. So if we're not running in an alarm state, the i-ALERT is going to trend the data once an hour, and we save that data for 30 days. As far as analytics are concerned, we do have the capability to again pull FFTs and time waveforms. It'll do this on alarm. or it'll also do it, you can send it a manual request when you're within communication range. And if you had any previous prior FFTs that were pulled, you can access those from here as well. Equipment information, this is where you would go in and adjust your alarm and warnings. You can put in all the equipment details, change the tag number. If it's a Goulds pump, you can put in the serial number and it'll allow you to access the parts list and all the original pump information, the materials of construction, the size, the model, the pump curve, etc. So some really useful features there. And the last thing I'm going to show you today is the report generator. So real quickly and easily, if a problem machine is identified out in the field, the person who's collecting the data can generate a nice two-page PDF report with their FFTs in all three directions, time waveforms, your most recent data on the trends for temperature and vibration. It's got your runtime, information about who collected the, who generated the report, the machine, etc. And now from here, you can go ahead and email that out to maintenance, reliability, the Vibe group, whoever might need to know that there's an issue with that particular machine. So, and we'll kind of circle back and go back to the scan screen where we started, and that concludes our demo on the i-ALERT2, and that's it. Thanks. So, I don't know, do you have anything to add, Jeff?
Yeah, I was going to say, this monitor is not just for pumps. It's not just for Goulds pumps. You can put it on anybody's pumps, as well as any other piece of rotating equipment. Fans, blowers, compressors, turbines. If it rotates, you can use this to monitor vibration.